I am down, and oh, my soul so weary. When troubles come and my heart burden me, and I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. Raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more.
No. school. You were a great man and a brother, not just to us, but to all you came in contact with. You had such great dreams for yourself, but admiring your beautiful daughter, so much praise and love you had for her, as a father should always do. We will make sure that Laurentia is taken care of and loved just as you did for her. Death was never a fear of yours, and you often used to say, let me live my life and enjoy my food and everything that I want to do. After all, we only live once. You never failed to pull a smile on our faces, especially when we had a bad day. As siblings, we fought and we laughed and we cried. However, our love for each other never ceased. We will miss your presence. Things will never be the same after your demise, and won't be the same for a very long time. We are sorry that you had to go. We wish you were here right now with us all, but in all things we give glory to God. It is now our prayer that your soul will rest in perfect peace, and that you will also join our beautiful late mother. Rakwenko, as we all used to call you, just know that we love you and we will miss you. We wish things were different, but all the same, the Lord our God knows best. So we say that your soul rest in peace, and we send you all our love from all your siblings.
He worked hard to provide for us and always put my needs before his own. One of the things I admire the most about my father was how he took me everywhere he goes. He never wanted me to miss out on any experiences, and I appreciate that so much. He also taught me how to cook and everything I need to know as a woman. He always wanted me to be prepared for anything life throws me away. My dad used to call me my Lori, as he used to call me. When my dad traveled abroad, he made sure to call me every day without fail. He couldn't reach me, he would send people to come and look for me, even if it was midnight. He always wanted to make sure I was safe and taken care of. Dad, you have been my rock and my support system throughout my entire life. I am so lucky to have had you as my dad, and I will always cherish the memories we shared together. Thank you for being my best dad a girl could ask for. Dad, I love you so much, and I will miss you. Dear, rest in peace. You will forever be in my memories.
And I will trust in you.
Your goodness. He's also, he was a built man, kind of, so he's a bit heavy. So let's put him and wheel him across. I said, that is fine. Let's do it that way. So he had a stature. He had a manliness that made him stand as a man. But he is not with us. He's gone. You see, for whatever we are about and doing, we might think that we are well known. We are succeeding. We are making very good progress with our lives. But once, as a grass, the wind blows and then you are no more, it takes only a number of years. And sometimes the memory of you even wipes away. Are you with me? Let the Lord faithful. Once you do that, your life will be alive with Christ forever. And even in death, you will still live. And life forevermore is what will be your portion. I pray that you don't leave here just like coming to any funeral and just listening and going, but to do something to your life, to put you in a place where you'll be ready and prepared for any eventuality, for whatever day, so that you can be with the Lord forever. May the Lord bless you for the hearing of His word. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Oh, mercy, we will all respond to hear our prayer. Lord, in your mercy.
Yeah.
Lord, mercy. Dear friends of life, you have made us in your image to reflect your truth and light. We give you thanks for Emmanuel, Koku, and Su, Rich P, for the grace and mercy he received from you, for all that was good in his life, for the memories we treasure today. Especially we thank you for his hard work and dedication to family and humanity. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, help us to accept Rich P's death and find comfort in knowing he is at peace in your loving care. Lord, we pray for all the family and friends of Emmanuel. We ask you, Lord, to give comfort and love to his child, his siblings, and all gathered here. We also pray for all relations who couldn't be here. May your strength and courage be with us and them. Watch over everyone and grant the grace to continue to live by his good example with love and kindness as he gave to the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Your mighty power brings joy out of grief and life out of death. Look in mercy on all relations who mourn. Give them in us patient faith in this time of darkness, and strengthen all with the knowledge of your love. Lord, in your mercy. At this very moment, I invite all of us to stand, and we're going to observe a minute of silence. Into your gracious keeping, O merciful God, we commend your servant now before us, Emmanuel, Kwaku, and Su, whom we also refer to as Kwaku Rich P. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the joy of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of his mom and all his relations who have all gone ahead, and all the saints in light, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
We say together the prayer that Jesus gave us. Our Father,
I'm going to go to the next one. And to add on that, all Methodist Church members, thank you so much for supporting me, and I really appreciate for everything that you have done for me and my family. May God bless you, all. Thank you.
And now to him who is able to keep you from falling and lift you from the dark despair of to the bright mountain of hope, from the midnight of desperation to the daybreak of joy, to him be power and authority forever and ever. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you forever. Amen.
Oh, and auntie.
Assim.